next few committees and what's expected to come up. And things can slip, can things can be withdrawn, things can be added, but this is just an opportunity for us to just quickly look at the work programme and check that we're happy with the schedule of the next few meetings. Any comments on that?
The Golders Green Town Strategy is that people be surprised that the majority of Golders Green Ward is not in Golders Green, as many council guards and Charles Hill and it was about doing six councils in North Twitch was interesting, doing nine in Golders Green would be very interesting. And the rest of the citizens.
That's why we need a unified strategy.
Yes. Yeah. And that will come up, and the councils are all. I've been involved with councils from all different boards, and certainly we've got this green on the shedding of that. Councillor Conway?
Yeah, just noting the Burnsgate Broadway proposal for September. I'm just wondering, picking up on what you've been saying here about residents and the need to be involved and engaged in developments in their area, I appreciate it's a different scale. But I'm a bit concerned as the councillor there that this will come to a meeting in September without anyone having seen plans locally that we talked about. I'm aware that there are worries locally as to what might be happening with leases on the high street and things being locked down, etc. And I just think it doesn't build confidence with local residents. I'm also conscious in Burnsgate that there's planned parks regeneration, there's youth zone going on, there's a lot of changes happening, and that is creating quite a lot of noise on the ground, and I just think it could be much better managed by talking to residents before proposals come here. You know, with something in the library, maybe an actual face-to-face at the community, because quite a lot of the community, particularly old members, aren't online. Obviously, Crazy Council came to something recently, and some local residents, we need to be out there in the communities here. Thank you.
It's a fair point. I know the community has been engaged with the youth zone, which is a huge investment and a positive development, obviously. But I take the point that you can have too much going on points. This is an outline business case, so this is the very first stages. So what we wouldn't want to do now is take an outline business case that could, when it comes to full business case, could well change. And we'd like to have at least a sort of concrete proposal or to take two residents, not a final proposal, but at least something that we know is deliverable. If we start consulting too early on, you can have a problem with managing expectations as well. So there is a point of actually it's a sweet spot when to go out to the public on this. I don't know if you've got anything more to say on what will be in that report at this stage. But of course, when the time comes, we will very much make sure that we engage with the councils and the community.
Okay, we're now being excluded. Bye-bye.